When Captain Cook landed on Hawaii Island, he found the Hawaiian people a completely sustainable people. Everything the Hawaiians needed, they made themselves. The Hawaiian Islands, a series of volcanic peaks in the middle of the Pacific Ocean, are collectively the most isolated landmass on the planet. The Hawaiians, as an island people, produce 100% of their food, even though they live thousands of miles away from the nearest land. Today, Hawaii imports 85% of its food. Sustainable? Food security? No. But why? Hawaii has adequate rain, sunshine, and a year-round growing season. Hawaii is absolutely ideal for agriculture. We have the natural capacity to grow all the food we need and more. So, why aren't we? Rising fuel costs lead directly to increases in the price of petroleum-derived fertilizers, which leads to higher costs in feed. It costs money to ship all that feed and fertilizer thousands of miles. By the way, it's just as expensive to import organic fertilizer, feed, and compost. Labor is expensive. It takes money to pay an agricultural worker enough to make a living wage. Costs of agriculture are increasing. Economic viability is decreasing. Agriculture in Hawaii is in serious trouble. Some say it's already on the verge of collapse. If agriculture in Hawaii collapses, Hawaii, the entire state, will be dependent on outside sources far across the sea just to eat. It doesn't have to be this way. If that happened, it wouldn't be a natural disaster. It would be economic famine. There is a solution, and that solution is called Korean natural farming. First, let me explain what natural farming is. In nature, everything grows perfectly. No one goes into the forest and tills the ground and prunes and fertilizes. No one's ever vigilant with herbicides, pesticides, compost, mulch. In nature, there's no waste, there's no pollution. Nature has a natural balance and a cyclic rhythm, and it's that balance and rhythm that natural farming tries to imitate. Work in harmony with nature, don't fight it. Okay. With natural farming, they use the natural cyclic, the natural life cycle of plants and animals. They employ the use of beneficial microbes, and they do this with the inputs made by the farmer using locally available feed. Materials that are locally available, often free, sometimes low cost. Yields are higher and quality is better. This is a picture of an egg that I grew. I could hold it for about a minute without it breaking. It only fell out of my hand because it was slippery. It was developed by Hung Kyu Cho, known as Master Cho. It's been used for over 30 years in over 37 countries. No special equipment is required. It can be used in very poor countries with little infrastructure or capital resources. The animals can be raised using no heating in the winter and no cooling in the summer, with no problems of pollution, disease, or smell. Let's talk for a minute about the smell. The smell of a piggery can carry for miles, and the smell is absolutely vile. The first Korean natural farming piggery in the United States was built here in Curtistown at Kang Farms. I've been there. It uses an inoculated deep litter system that allows the pigs to dig. So even though the pigs are confined, the pigs can act like pigs. As you can see, they're clean and content. When I was there, I could smell a little hay smell, maybe a little bread yeast, but I couldn't smell the pigs at all, not even right inside the piggery. And the piggery does not have to be cleaned out for years. Imagine having pigs, never cleaning, and still no smell, no flies, no pollution, no disease. Other animals can be raised this way as well. Without heat, baby chicks die. In Korean natural farming, they're put in a specially constructed box, and the heat of the microbes is actually enough to keep the baby chicks alive without brooding hens, without artificial heating, and they still have access to exercise, food, and water. Health and welfare, comfort and happiness of animals are very important to the natural farmer. And remember, these animals are being fed with locally available materials. No feed needs to be imported. It is so expensive to import feed, it is now cheaper to take a calf born in Hawaii, ship it to the mainland, feed it there, and then ship the meat back to Hawaii. And with rising transportation and shipping costs, how can Hawaii expect to grow its own meat? The answer is with Korean natural farming using locally produced feed. Let's look at some of the issues that farmers face in growing food. Good soil is needed to grow food. In Korean natural farming, topsoil is created rather than destroyed. It improves the soil continually rather than being more and more depleted year after year. It can be used to heal dead, devastated soil, bringing marginal agricultural soils back to life. This is a no-till system. Soil organisms and small soil animals such as worms are used to do the tilling, as happens in nature. A worm can dig as deep as 7 meters. It's about 20 feet. They take with them in their gut microbes wherever they dig and create soil wherever they go. Rocks can even be turned into soil. This is being demonstrated on a hard rocky lava flow in Kona at the University of Nations. One of the reasons worms dig so deep is to look for water, and water is a huge issue in agriculture. Master Cho talks about growing foods in a desert with no measurable rainfall. He put microbes in the soil, and the morning dew is enough water to grow crops where it never rains. Keep in mind, soil organisms are 80 to 85% water. They're essentially a water reservoir. Pests and disease, huge problems for the grower, but these are mitigated with Korean natural farming. In nature, no job goes unfilled. If all parts of the ecosystem, plant, animal, microbe, are filled with beneficial organisms, then opportunistic, pathogenic organisms don't have a chance. The continual addition of microbes to the system ensures that all the jobs in the system are filled and disease has little chance. Insects like to attack fat plants, meaning they've been fed an abundance of nitrogen. These succulent, juicy, nitrogen-fat plants are highly susceptible to insect attacks. By properly feeding plants so they don't become fat or weak, they're protected against attack. Korean natural farming, when used as a complete system, is able to defend and protect against pests and diseases. Weeds, another big problem. Remember our role model, nature, no fight. Weeds are everywhere. Weeds can be left growing under the crop to establish a ground cover. I used to fight the weeds in my garden, and now I have this nice ground cover. Very effective in keeping weeds out. Another tool would be mulch. All is needed is a layer 3 to 5 times deeper than the size of the seed, and the weed seed cannot sprout and grow. The nutritive cycle can also be used to control weeds. What is this cycle? The nutritive cycle addresses the nutritional needs of plants based on life cycle stages. The decision what to feed, when to feed, is not based on math. It's not based on how many pounds per acre per crop per year. It's based on observation. What are some of the things that are fed to plants in Korean natural farming? One of the cornerstones is IMO, Indigenous Microorganisms. In this picture, you can see a culture being collected in a bamboo forest. These are collected on rice in a specific way near where the crops are grown. The fuzzy rice in the Lalhalla basket is what that culture looks like. That culture is called IMO number one. IMO number one is then fed sugar and becomes IMO number two. In this form, the culture can be stored indefinitely. IMO number two is inoculated and grown out on a carbohydrate source, such as rice bran, wheat meal run, bagasse. It's again added, soil is added to this, and it's again grown out and becomes IMO number four. This is the main form of microbes used. In this form, it can also be stored indefinitely. It is often used in conjunction with biochar. 1 gram of biochar has the surface area of a tennis court, offering lots of housing for microbes. IMO is added to soil, to animal bedding, and in the weekly foliar sprays. So what kind of inputs are used to make the weekly foliar sprays? Things like fruit. This is green papaya that I'm fermenting. I don't know if you can see the bubbles. Weeds, plants, fruit, milk, sugar, eggs, vinegar, fish scraps, bones. All are safe, non-toxic, and most are edible. In conclusion, Korean natural farming is based on the nutritive cycle, local microbes, and the connection of human to our food. The crux of it is this: if we disconnect ourselves from our food supply, we isolate our own nature. Humans cannot live alone. We cannot even digest the food we eat alone. We need the microbes in our gut for that. The system does not work in bits and pieces because it's an integrated system, and we are part of that system called life. In using and sharing Korean natural farming, we are able to create a global model of sustainability and abundance on Hawaii Island. Mahalo.